Hello everyone, thank you so much for watching this video. This video is all about why is that money karma so important to know. I keep getting a lot of this question as well. Why I have to check this? Why I have to know this? Why I have to learn this? So let me tell you, divine knowledge is the very precious knowledge, I would say. So one of the interesting subject is astrology. There are a lot of people who are very crazy about astrology. There are a lot of people who have belief on astrology. They follow each and everything based upon the astrological predictions. They follow each and everything. If at all they want to start a new, if at all they want to buy a new house, if at all they want to buy a new car, if at all they want to start something new, they always look for the stars, they always look for astrological planets, they always go for a consultation, they always seek the astrological advice. Okay, so in fact this YouTube channel is also for all the astrological lovers out there. Okay, if at all you are not an astrological lover, let me tell you, these videos are very boring for you. I wish you can unsubscribe from my video, from my YouTube channel. I don't mind telling that, because if at all, if you are watching my videos and if you're not interested, if you don't have belief in astrology, it's just a waste of your time and my time. Okay. So it's very important to learn this astrological money karma, because the financial planets such as Venus, Jupiter, Saturn, Rahu determines your money karma as per Vedic astrology. So if at all Rahu, Venus, Saturn and Jupiter are sitting in a very good state, then obviously you will not be having much of financial problems in your life. Especially at least two planets should be supporting to you to have a very good financial karma in your life. Okay. So if at all Jupiter and Venus especially have been conjunct with Ketu, then that comes the problem in terms of your financial aspects. At least if Jupiter and Venus are afflicted, then Rahu and Saturn should be supporting in your birth chart. I've seen many horoscopes that way. So I've seen one of the horoscope wherein with Jupiter was sitting in Capricorn and Venus was sitting in Virgo. So both the planets which provides money are sitting in the bad state. But luckiest of him that planet Saturn is sitting in Libra. So Saturn becomes exalted. And Saturn is very strong compared to Jupiter and Venus. So although these two planets are sitting in the bad state, because of Saturn's blessing, this person is able to get all the hopes and wishes fulfilled, and also he is able to make a very good money in his life. And also Rahu should be supporting, if at all Rahu is placed in the 6th house, 8th house, 12th house, 11th house, 10th house and also the 3rd house, Rahu works really well. If Rahu is sitting in other places in your birth chart, obviously there comes a problem. So all those things will be thoroughly analyzed to check your money karma in your birth chart. It's very important for you to learn the money karma, because once you learn the money karma, you can able to forecast the financial situation in your life. You can able to estimate at what point of time you'll be having the crisis, at what point of time you'll be making very good money. Okay, so it doesn't mean that if at all your astrologer says if at all you make a tremendous money in the next 6 months, please don't go with a complete belief on that. The reason being because predictions vary depending upon the circumstances, depending upon the current life karma as well, which is called as Sanchita karma. Okay, so karma is of three kinds: Prarabdha karma, Sanchita karma and Agami karma. There is the karma, the birth chart planets determine the karmic balance of your previous lives, whereas your Sanchita karma talks about the karmic baggage in the current life. So even though your astrologer says that so and so thing will happen, it may not happen because of the reason the current life karmic baggage would be overpowering your good karma. So during that point of time also, there won't be something good, won't be happening in your life. And you don't need to really sit and worry for it, because definitely there are certain remedies which you can follow. And also you can able to see, first and foremost thing, you need to have belief, confidence on your own self. If you're not confident about your own self, you'll not be able to do anything in your life. So be self-confident, be motivated all the time. Acquire knowledge as much as you can, and also implement what you learn. Always action takers wins. The people who keep dreaming, they'll be still dreaming. Okay, so astrology is more of like a torchlight. It will show you the light in the darkness, but it doesn't take you to complete destination. You have to move from your chair. If your astrologer says that in the next 6 months, you know, you'll be getting a gold medal in your running race, and if you keep sitting and just wasting your time, you'll not be able to win that game. You have to do action. So that's why astrology carefully helps us to understand, provides you the direction, but it will not take you to the destination. It's all about, you need to perform your actions. You need to do your actions. So that's nothing but called karma. You have to go along with the cycle. Whatever happens in this life, it's all because of your past life, or your past life deeds. What are the events that you are facing? What are the problems that you are facing? It's because of the deeds that you performed in the past life. That's what astrology says. It doesn't mean that you need to sit at a corner and keep crying about, oh, my birth chart is very bad, my plans are very bad, what I need to do? No. Astrology is just like a prediction. And you need to step ahead and need to work upon your weaker areas. Let's say your birth chart, Mercury, is having some problem. Mercury is the planet of communication. Mercury is the planet of creativity. Mercury is the planet of decision making. Mercury is the planet of innovation. If Mercury is sitting in the bad state, and obviously all these attributes which I told you, you might not be able to give 100%. So you will start working upon it, and definitely you will come to that final point and you can able to reach that desired levels. So that's how you should take the astrology as a torchlight in your life. Okay, I hope it makes a lot of sense for you. So if at all you have bad plans in your birth chart, please don't worry. Please work upon your weaker areas and definitely you'll win through it. Okay, thank you so much. And if at all you need my astrological consultations, the link is mentioned in the description section. Do book for an astrological consultation. Once I get a consultation order, I'll be able to help you with the complete analysis pertaining to your individual birth chart. And also do mention about what are the current problems that you're facing in your birth chart. In your life, so that I can able to carefully analyze your birth chart from that perspective. I can able to rule out your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats, and also I can able to provide you some kind of remedies which you can able to work upon it and ease out the problems in your life. So thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video. And please book for an astrological consultation, and the link is mentioned in the description section. Bye for now.